नमस्कार ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः द सेकंड आवरण द सेकंड एंक्लोजर सर्व आश परिपूरक चक्र दिस नवावरण कृति सेट इन नागा कल्याणी एंड सेट टू आदिताला रेंड कलर The second enclosure, known as the Sarva Asha Paripuraka Chakra, the chakra that fulfills all the desires of the sadhaka. The presiding deity of this enclosure is Tripureshi, and her aids are all unmanifest, hidden, Gupta Yogini. The 16-petaled lotus, Shodashadala Padma, which is the fulfiller of all desires. In the 16 petals, the 16 vowels of Sanskrit alphabet are inscribed. These symbolize the 16 kalas or phases. This avarna is about self-protection of the devotee, atma raksha, and liberation from discontent by seeking identity with the Supreme, who is ever complete and content. Dikshitar calls upon the mind to meditate upon Kamalamba and cast aside attachments to kalpita maya, illusory existence. The craving asha springs from discontent and is quenched when discontent is eliminated. He worships the presiding deity of Sarva Asha Paripuraka Chakra, the fulfiller of all desires and expectations, including the removal of all dukkha, dukkha dvamshini, the beloved of Paramashiva, the bestower of true and everlasting bliss, Nirvana Nija Sukha Pradayinim. She is the manifestation of the attributeless Supreme Spirit, Nirvishesha Chaitanya Rupinim. She is also the representation of the world and its principles, Urvi Tattvadi Swarupinim. The 16 presiding deities in this second avarana, the one who draws forth all asha, kama akarshini, buddhi akarshini, ahamkara akarshini, chitta akarshini, etc., etc. So the 16 petals representing desire, intellect, ego, sound, touch, form, taste, smell, mind, courage, memory, name, seed, soul, immortality, and the body. This is set to Raga Kalyani. This composition from among the Navavarnas is probably the most commonly sung, performed composition in today's times in concerts, because the Kalyani in this shines like very beautiful, you know. And since Kalyani is a raga which is a very popular raga, this composition is sung very often in concerts. It is set to the Adi Talam of 8 beats, but when we put it in rendu kala, it becomes a total of 16. And this logic is of the order of the 16 lotus petals. This is the second avarna, and therefore, Dikshitar uses the dvitiya vibhakti, the accusative. In the raga mudra, Dikshitar uses the phrase nitya kalyani. She is both nitya and kalyani. He describes her as the remover of sorrow, the ultimate happiness, giver of ultimate happiness, which is salvation and liberation. Like I said, Kalyani beginning at the Panchama in this Raga the Kriti. The word Kamalamba itself affords a very beautiful device of Swara Akshara, where the Ka Ma Lam Ba suggests the Gamapa usage very readily and very beautifully. So this Kriti is replete with the Gamapa and Kamalamba. Kamalamba, in different places in the Kriti, the highlight of the Kriti in terms of its compositional dexterity and skill is the very beautiful usage of Swara Akshara. the beginning itself. Kamalambam gamapa kamalambam bhajare re manasa kalpita gamapa maya karyam tyajare tyajare that rishabha kalpita maya karyam tyajare kamala the anupallavi also kamala vani the same gamappa sevita pa the tapa is dhapa similarly in the charanam also there is a very prevalent usage of this varakshara sarvasha paripuraka that also is sung the way I have learnt it sarvasha padi sapa sapadi this swarakshara is very beautiful then durva dapa then in the raga mudra comes nirvana nija sukha pradayini nitya kalyani nit even that nishada nitya kalyani katya sarvani sapama madupa madapa vijaya veni saguru gajanani niranjani so you find that the very very overarching use of swarakshara gives this kriti a very beautiful dimension in the sangeeta sampradaya pradarshini of subrahma dikshita there is also a chitta swara given for this navavarna the only navavarna where there is a chitta swara and the beautiful very very unique aspect of this chitta swara is that it is a palindrome palindrome meaning if you sing it forwards or if you sing it backwards it is the same swaras that result sari ga ma da ni ri ga pa da ma da ni ga sa ri ni ri ga ni sa ni ri sa ni di da da pa pa da ga ni ni sa di ni sa ni ga ri ni di sa ga ni da ma da ba ga ri ni da ma ga ri sa ka ma la sa di ga ma da ni ri ga pa da ma ga ni ga sa di ni di ga ni sa ni ri sa ni ni da da pa pa da ga ni ni sa di ni sa ni ga ri ni di sa ga ni da ma da ba ga ri ni da ma ga ri sa ka ma la ba ba ja pe re ma na sa kal pi ta ma ya ka kamalamba bhajare re manasa kalpita maya karyam tyajare o mind worship goddess kamalamba and attachments to worldly desires fall away which are anyway illusory tyajare abandon renounce them kamalavani sevita parshvam this extols this particular goddess Kamalamba, who is flanked by Lakshmi and Saraswati on both sides. A very beautiful kind of manifestation, representation. Kambujaya Grivam, the neck that surpasses the beauty of the conch shell. Natadevam, who is received by God's bow down. Kamalapura Sadanam, Mridugadanam, who resides in the lotus city, Kamalapura. Mridugadanam, whose speech is sweet and tender. Kamaniya Radanam, who has charming teeth. Kamalavadanam, face like that of the lotus. Sarvasha Paripuraka Chakra Swaminim, Paramasivakaminim, beloved of Supreme Lord Shiva and the granter of all wishes, 16 devatas. Durvasa Archita Gupta Yoginim, who is also worshipped by the sage Durvasa and her secret yoginis. Dukha Dvamsinim, destroying all sufferings. Hamsinim, who rides the swan. Nirvana Nija Sukha Pradayinim, who grants salvation and the bliss of one's own self. Nija Sukha Pradayinim, Nitya Kalyanin, who is ever auspicious. Katyayanim, the daughter of sage Katyayana. Sharvani, who is Sharvani, the consort of Sharva, Shiva. Madhupa Vijayavenim, whose hair conquers the blackness of honeybees. Sadguru Guha Jananim, the mother of Lord Guru Guha. Niranjanim, who is without Anjana, blemishless. Garvita Bhandasura Bhanjanim, Kamakarshinyadi Ranjanim, who destroyed the arrogant demon Bhanda. Kamakarshinyadi Ranjanim, who delights the devatas such as Kamakarshini, etc. Nirvishesha Chaitanya Rupini, who is the embodiment of unqualified consciousness. Urvi Tattvadi Swarupini, who is manifest in the elements such as earth, the five elements. Let us now listen to this Kriti in all its glory.